Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Welcome to our December Youth Auxiliary Service. As you come, I ask that you share the live. We're going to go ahead. Well, I guess I got to do it by myself, but we're going to go ahead and get started just with a song as we share. You see me looking at my phone. I'm sharing as well. But Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me home. Jesus, I'll never forget, no, never. How can I forget what you've done for me? How can I forget how you set me free? How can I forget how you brought me out? Jesus, I'll never forget, no, never. Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget, no, never. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Again, unfortunately, see your faces, but as you join the live, I pray that you are joining with the heart of worship. I pray that you are joining with the heart of expectation. I pray that you are joining with the mindset that says that I will bless the Lord at all times and that praise shall continually be on my lips. I pray that you are joining with a mindset that says that this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it again. I'm asking that you share the live, share it with your friends, share it with your coworkers, share it with your family, share it with your youth, share it with your young at heart. But come in for just a moment with a heart of praise wherever you may be. No, we're not in our sanctuary. Yes, we're all in our various locations. But if we can just be found all on one accord with the same spirit, if we can just be found with the same mindset, and the same expectation, I truly do believe, I truly expect God to move. I truly expect someone to receive what it is they need to receive, whether it be they just need to be found in the midst of the fellowship, whether it be they need a word that strengthens them, whether it be they need the songs of Zion come on with the expectation of worship. Again, I can't see your face. I can't see how. I can't hear you. I can't hear your praise, but the Lord does hear your praise. The Lord does hear your hallelujah. The Lord does hear you saying, thank you, Jesus. He hears you and he is still yet expecting a praise from you. He's still worthy of the praise. He's still a good God. He's still worthy of all the worship. As we begin to move forward in the service, we're going to have, we're going to have Sister Trina come and lead us in a word of prayer as we open up the service. Immediately following her, we're going to have Brother Brandon give us a word of, we're going to give us our scripture word, and then we're going to have Minister Brianna Curtis come and lead us in praise and worship. So at this time, the service is in the hands of Sister Trina.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. We are going to give God praise on tonight for our youth service. We're going to exalt God. If you can just close your eyes and bow your head in the cyber sanctuary, in the temple of your home, just bow your head. We're going to go before the throne of grace. Father God, we thank you, Lord God. We thank you for another opportunity to gather, Lord God, to give your name the praise, the glory, and the honor, Lord God. Oh God, you say we enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise, Lord God. So we will let out a praise of hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, we will exalt you on tonight, Lord God. Oh God, we will decrease, Lord God, so that you can increase and get the glory on tonight, Lord God. Go before us, Lord God. Oh God, let Carla bring forth the word, Lord God, that you have placed in her heart, Lord God. Let somebody be saved through this broadcast, Lord God. Let somebody have an itching ear to want to know who Jesus Christ is through this service, God. Oh, God, we ask that you send healing through the airways, God, in the name of Jesus, to every person that is sick, broken, or, Lord God, just needing of a healing on tonight, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us a mindset to praise you, Lord God, because this is a heart thing, and you have to have a heart and a mind to serve you in spirit and in truth, Lord God. So we thank you, we bless you, and we count it all joy, Lord God. We count it all done, Lord God. We ask that you would just have your way, Lord God, that this service will go accordingly, Lord God, that you will remove any distractions, God, so that every ear that is attached to this service tonight will hear what it is that you have to say. In your holy, mighty name we pray, God. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. I'll be coming from Philippians 4, verses 8 through 9. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me do, and the God of peace shall be with you. And the word is already blessed.
Praise the Lord, everyone. We know that we're doing things a little bit differently. I'm going to sing two songs and get out your way. If you know them, you can sing along. We got our little instrumentals over here. So bear with us, but God bless us. Amen. Doing an older song, even though it's a youth service. Amen. Hallelujah.
Heartaches, I've had my share of heartaches, but I'm still here. Trouble, I've seen my share of trouble, but I'm still here. Bruises, I've had my lumps and bruises, but I'm still here. Loneliness, I've taken my share of loneliness, but I'm still here. Through it all, I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. Light on, many times I've been light on, but I'm still here. Burdens, had to bear many burdens, but I'm still here. Dark days, many times I've had dark days, but I'm still here. Disappointments, I've had so many disappointments, but I'm still here. Through it all, I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. It's by the grace of God that I'm still here today. is always right there. No matter what came my way, and with the prayers and help in the time of need, standing right there just to see about me. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. I made it. Yes, I made it. I'm still here. I made it. Yes, I made it. I'm still here. I made it. Yes, I made it. I'm still here. I made it. Yes, I made it. I'm still here. I made it. Yes, I made it. I'm still here. I made it through another day's journey. I'm still here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Just so grateful just to still be here. You know, we go through things even, you know, through the midst of this pandemic, beyond, you know, the sickness and all the disease that's going around. It's really been a transition for a lot of us. And, you know, we just really have to just thank the Lord that we are still here, not just being ungrateful. I can't do this and I can't do that. And I'm frustrated with this and I'm frustrated with that. We just have to be grateful. Lord, I just want to thank you that I am still here. That's it. You know, he doesn't have to give us another breath. What, regardless of what's going on or what's not, even if we weren't in the midst of the pandemic, we're not promised another breath. And so we have to just be mindful and just have a heart of gratefulness beyond everything that, you know, we desire or whatever it is that we're going through, just to just thank the Lord. You know, God, I thank you for just being here. The next song that I'm going to sing is a newer song. Again, bear with us because this is, you know, a little different for all of us, including me right now. But it's a newer song. We're jumping from the old to the new. But if you know this song, you can feel free to sing it as well. Amen. Miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. And right now, we're standing right here. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. And your voice is drawing us near. And right now, I know you're able, and my God, come through again. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost the battle. No, you never lost the battle. And I know, you never will. Everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost, and your voice is calling up now. When the storms are up, like the tune of the miracle. And your voice is crashing down. And right now, I know you're able. And my God, come through again. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost the battle. No, you never lost the battle. I know you never will. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost the battle. No, you never lost the battle. I know you never win. Never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never win. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never will. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never will. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You never lost the battle. You can do all. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost the battle. No, you never lost the battle. I know you never will. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost the battle. No, you never lost the battle. I know you'll never win. You'll never win. You never
will. Hallelujah. We know that God has never lost a battle. Y'all, excuse me for forgetting some of the words of that song, because I know you noticed that. Hallelujah. But God has never lost a battle. I just hope that you are encouraged this evening. We're going to have Minister Carla come up and give the word. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen, amen. Can we take just a moment to be grateful for the fact that the God we serve has never lost a battle? Can we take just a moment to be grateful for the fact that the God we serve will never lose a battle? Somebody on today needs to hear that God did not lose 2020. Somebody on today needs to hear that God did not lose when it comes to this pandemic. Somebody on today needs to hear that God did not lose when it comes to our government, because the word will let us know that the government is upon his shoulders. Someone on today may be going through. Someone on today may be weary. Someone on today may be in pain. Someone on today may be hurting. Some are grieving. Many are tired. But someone on today needs to hear that the God that you served, hallelujah, has never lost a battle. I know that we came into the year with certain expectations and we're going out of the year not having some of them realized, but you need to understand that the God that we serve, this Jesus that loves us so much so, has yet to lose a battle. No, it may not have happened on our time. No, it may not have happened according to what we believed or what we thought, but the God that we serve has never lost a battle. So for those who are yet still waiting on on a promise to be manifested, for a situation to be resolved, for a pain to be comforted, a pain to be removed. I need you to understand that God has never lost a battle. Wherever you are, wherever you may be watching the live, whether you are in your vehicle, whether you are in your bedroom, whether you are in your living room, whether you are even in your bathroom, take just a moment to worship God. Take just a moment to praise God and thank Him for the fact that this, despite everything that has happened this year, despite the fact that so many people want to throw the year away, you're still here, you're still standing, you're still strong, you're still saved, you're still trusting, you're still hoping, you're yet still holding on. Your God has never lost a battle. Yes, it's been a long day's journey. Yes, it's been a long year for some, but take just a moment to realize that you're still here running. You're still in the race. You're still walking. You're still striving. You're still reaching out for God. Take just a moment to be thankful for that, to praise Him for that. If you don't have anything else to praise God for, let it be, God, I'm still saved here in December 2020. I am still saved. No, you may not have gotten the job you want. No, you may not have gotten the spouse you desire. No, you may not have gotten the home that you wanted. No, the family member may not be saved yet. They may have not responded yet. But at the end of 2020, when so many have turned away from the faith and so many have turned away from the gospel and so many are found compromising and so many are found giving up and mental health seems to be at the forefront and it seems as though black bodies can't do enough to survive, you and I are still here standing. We still have our joy. We still have our peace. We have not lost our minds. We have not thrown in the towel. I'm in the comfort of my home and not a jail cell. I'm in the comfort of my home and a mental hospital. I'm in the comfort of my home and not out in the streets because I'm homeless or whatever the case could have been, or whatever the case actually should have been and would have been. But here on today, I am grateful. I'm grateful to God for the fact that I am saved. I'm grateful to God for the fact that I'm yet holding on. I'm grateful to God for the fact that I can be still found in a place. No, I'm not in the sanctuary, but I am found in the service. And maybe you feel as though you've praised for yourself. Maybe you feel as though you don't have anything extra to give God praise for, but there are some of ours, there are some of our own that are hurting right now. There are some of our own that are heavy right now. There are some of our own that are going through right now. If you could take just a moment to walk in the spirit of an intercessor and be like, well, Lord, this next praise, this next worship is for my brother. This next worship is for my sister. This next worship is so that you will go and see about them. No, I don't know the details, God, but I can see it weighing on their soul. I can see it weighing on their mind. And Lord, I know that you are a good God, not just for me, but you're a good God for them. I know that you're a way maker, God. Be a way maker for them. I know that you are a miracle worker. Lord, be a miracle worker for them. Lord, I know that you're a healer. Heal for them. Lord, I know that you're a provider. Provide for them. Lord, I know that you are still saving souls. Lord, go and save their soul. Go and save their family member's soul. Go and save their co-workers. Lord, I know how to praise you for myself, but in this moment, I want to take just a moment to praise you for my brother and my sister, for the ones that I claim that are family, for the ones that I fellowship with on every week. I go and see every Sunday. I haven't seen them in a while, Lord. I don't know what all is going on. I don't know what all they are dealing with. I'm not just going to sit here and assume that they backslid. I'm not just going to sit here and assume that they're giving up on you. But Lord, I'm going to go in my personal closet for them. Can we take just a moment, hallelujah, Jesus, to thank God, hallelujah, that we are still here, that we are still standing, and that at the end of the day, the Lord is our strength. The Lord is our strength. The Lord is our strength. I'm grateful. I'm grateful for the fact that despite the circumstances, we are still yet able to come together. We're still able to have the rooms. We're still able to go live. We had some technical difficulties, but this service was going to happen one way or another. I do believe that God has a word for his people that desire to hear it. I give honor to my leaders in the persons of District Elder Charles and Lady Barbara Shelton. I am grateful for the workers in the ministry that I work alongside with. I'm grateful for all those who are on the live. I'm grateful for those who even had a desire to be with us, but life happens, and I understand that. I'm grateful for the youth that I fellowship with. I know that I am a youth leader, but one thing I'm grateful for that I can always look to them, and they themselves are an example to me. I don't plan to be before you long. I really don't. I understand that, you know, by the time December comes, most people, they want a happy word. They want to be preached happy. Preach to me so I dance. But I'm going to let you know right now, that is not the type of word I have for you today. I wanted to preach a happy word. And when I asked God what it is that he desired for me to give, it was more so a word to strengthen the saints and to strengthen the people. So if I seem like I'm in your business, I promise you I'm not. If it seems like I'm blunt or I'm coming off hard, I promise you I'm not. I'm simply going to say what it is God has given me to say. And because the fact of the matter is, I don't want us to just be happy in the natural. I want us to be strengthened in the spirit and God be pleased with us. So with that being so, if you would follow me, come with me, grab your Bibles, grab your Bible app, whatever it is that you have. We're going to read two passages of scriptures. You're going to notice me calling out scripture throughout the message. You can write it down if you're the type like me that takes notes. But for now, the two passages of scripture I want to go to are Philippians chapter 2, verses 5. I guess I should turn there as well. Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 through 8. And then immediately following that, we're going to go to Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. Give me just a moment. I'm actually going to mute. Oh, no, I won't be able to mute them. Never mind. I'm going to stop playing stuff because I'm messing stuff up. But Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 through 8. And it reads, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross." Flipping over, we're going to Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. Brother Jordan, I appreciate you for putting that in the comments because I was about to ask someone to do so. Galatians 6, verse 9 is a familiar scripture to us. It would say to us, "And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." Before we go in, I just want to say a quick word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you for this day, God. I thank you for this service, God. I thank you, Lord God, for the spirit of worship and praise that I trust is at each and every home on today, God. I'm thankful for the opportunity to sit amongst your people and serve on another occasion. I'm grateful for the opportunity, oh God, to give this word, God. I'm praying that I decrease and you increase in me, God. I'm praying, oh God, that this message be delivered by you through the Holy Ghost, and that I understand that I am nothing more than a vessel, God. I am nothing more than how you decided to go about delivering this word, God. I pray that your people be strengthened. I pray, oh God, that they hear and receive what it is that they need, oh God. And as we prepare to transition into this new year, God, I pray that we go into this new year strong, not in ourselves, but in you, strong in our holy, strong in our stand. God, have your way. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. 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 So I have my notes in front of me if I'm looking down, but just for a moment, I want to speak from the topic with the help of the Holy Ghost, the perseverance of the servant. If I was to have a subtopic, I would simply say there is still a work to do. The perseverance of the servant, there's still a work to do. I understand that this year has been like nothing anyone has expected. Many have died suddenly and unexpectedly. We've lost both idols and greats in the church and in the natural alike. Many have fallen. Many are trying not to lose their minds under the circumstances, and many have just become tired. It's been a tiring year for many, but yet still, some have finally stepped into what it is that God has desired of them. Some have been able to prosper. Many have grown. Many have healed. Many have stepped into a closer relationship with God. But many have set their face to the plow to do the work that God has called them to. But yet here we are 9 months later, and some of the servants are tired, whether it be life just beating at you, whether it be that you yourself have not given the 100% that God has expected or asked of you. We've come to a time and a place where a lot of the servants are growing tired. And the fact of the matter is that not everyone that claims to be a servant is found working. Serving in 2020 has the same end goal, but unfortunately, it doesn't always have the same process. The church finds itself having to be creative and tech savvy. And as I mentioned earlier, we were having unexpected technical difficulties that we should not have been having. But yet the case may be that we're going to run into technical difficulties trying to do church in this new way. In a season where it's of the utmost importance that one holds on tight to their own salvation and their own walk, pastors and leaders and prayer warriors and intercessors and just examples alike are finding themselves having to do that much the more and push that much more the harder to keep their sheep engaged, strengthened, and instructed. But I want to say to every servant, if you identify yourself as a servant, this is for you. I want to say to you that be sure to persevere. Be sure to let no quit be found in you, because the times may weary you, but do not grow weary in well-doing. My reasoning and my concern for this and the fact that the servants are tired is that if the servants get tired, how does the work get done? God uses disciples in order to spread the gospel, to spread the message. Yes, we understand that Paul had a different encounter with Jesus, but yet Paul still got sent to Ananias to find out what it is that he needed to know. So when Jesus departed the earth, he commissioned the disciples to go about and to teach and to spread the gospel. So if we today are supposed to be doing what the disciples then did, if we get tired, how does the work get done? How does the gospel continue to spread? Romans 10, 13 through 15 would say to us, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Yes, we understand that we are in a pandemic. Yes, we understand that we need to be safe. Yes, we understand that we need to walk wise, but we also need to understand that the scripture yet remains true. If we believe that those that call on the name of the Lord shall be saved, we have an obligation to tell someone about this name that we ourselves have called in. If we believe that those who call on the name of the Lord shall be saved, we have an obligation to tell the world, to tell different ones about this God that we serve and testify to the fact that we serve and believe in him. And I understand that many churches are closed. I understand that many aren't able to give a word from the pulpit, but the fact of the matter is, if you can go live on Facebook about any and everything else, you can go live on Facebook and give a testimony. If you can go live on Facebook about any and everything else, you can go live on Facebook and share the revelation of the word that God has given you. But understand that many aren't able to preach from the pulpit. You can't come and hoop and holler over the pulpit and scream in the mic. But the fact of the matter is, if you can comment your opinion on everyone's social media and on everyone's status and on everyone's Instagram story, you can comment the fact that Jesus saves when you see someone or your neighbor, your brother or your sister going through. You can comment. It doesn't take much to say, well, I know you understand this, but Acts 2 and 38 will tell us otherwise. I know that you understand it this way, but the revelation of the Spirit will have me to understand that that is not the case. We can do all of these things when it comes to what we want to do, but yet when it's time to show, give a word, and when it's time to be that witness, now we have the excuse that, well, I'm not at my church. Well, I'm not in the sanctuary. Well, you're still going to Walmart. Well, you're still going to drive through. Well, you can still get your hands on some tracts. And if you have the excuse that, well, I can't get tracts from my church, you actually can go to Pentecostal Publishing and order your own set of tracts. Talk to your pastor, your leader, whomever that may be, and let them know you simply want to be a witness. And you can actually make the sacrifice to do so. Because the fact of the matter is, especially with my generation, when we want to do something, we're going to find a way. When we want to be somewhere, we're going to find a way to get there, whether we're late, whether we miss it. It's just the fact that we wanted to be there. So now we have to ask ourselves, well, is it the fact that the church is closed, or is it the fact that we no longer want to work? Is it the fact that the church is closed and everything is virtual in some places, or is it the fact that we now all of a sudden want to be comfortable? We now feel as though we have a break. We have to be mindful of the excuses we give, because God will check your heart and show you that you are lying. Because the fact of the matter is, whether or not you are a preacher, it should be said that you are a witness. Whether or not you have a position, whether or not you have a title, whether or not you have a clergy collar, whether or not you have a pin on your suit jacket, it should be said that you are a witness. It should be able to be said about you that you've been sent. Matthew 28, verse 19 and 20 would give us the Great Commission, and it would say to us, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. And if I can pause right here, just for any guests that we have on, I need you to understand that the name of the Father is Jesus. The name of the Son is Jesus. The name of the Holy Ghost is Jesus. Verse 20 will go on and say, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. Notice that I didn't say sent to be a pastor. Mm-hmm. Notice I didn't say sent to be a first lady. Notice I didn't say sent to have a position or a title, to sit on a certain seat on the pulpit, to be able to MC the service, to be able to be seen. I simply said sent. The fact of the matter is, I didn't even say sent. The scripture said sent. The scripture said go. The disciples were sent out initially to spread the gospel, and the same goes for us. We are sent out to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're sent out to say that Jesus died and that Jesus was buried. And the fact, despite the fact that he was wrapped up in these clothes, in these grave clothes, despite the fact that they laid him on the tomb, that his body was lifeless, despite the fact that they rolled this huge boulder to cover the cave they put him in, Jesus still rose. We're sent out to tell a lost and a dying world that Jesus loves, so Jesus saves. Oh, yeah. Because I'm reminded of the example, and Sister Bree and Brother Brandon, they can attest to this. As for me personally, when food is good to you, you may or you may not share it, but if I do share it, you're gonna hear me say that you better know I love you, because the food I was eating was good to me, and I wanted you to experience at the cost of my own sacrifice. You better know that I love you. But here I must ask the question, do we have enough love for our neighbor to tell them that Jesus saved. You don't have enough love to let someone know that things are bad right now, but there's an expected end that you can have if you choose Jesus. We must ask ourselves, has our love waxed cold during this pandemic? Has our love waxed cold in 2020? Have we forgotten what it really meant to say that we love? Have we forgotten that love bears all, that love suffers wrong? That have we forgotten what it really means to say that we love someone, or we say that we are showing love? We have to ask ourselves, has our love waxed cold, or are we yet still a city set on a hill that cannot be hid? I have to take a moment to tell you that, dear servant, do not let this pandemic hide you. Don't think that now that we're in a pandemic, and now that churches are closing, and now we open back up, but now we're having to shut back down again, you have a reason to hide. You have a reason to not be found doing what it is that God has asked of you. You have a reason to be found not serving, because the fact of the matter is that is a lie straight from the pit of hell. Do not let this pandemic hide you, because the fact of the matter is things might get darker, but as things get darker, your light ought to shine that much the more brighter. As things get darker, your walk ought to bring that much the more attention. I'm not going to sit here and tell you and go with the flow and jump on the bandwagon and say that come January, Corona is going to all of a sudden disappear. I'm not going to jump on the bandwagon and say when Biden officially takes presidency, now all of a sudden things are going to seem like they make sense. I'm not even going to sit here and tell you that now that we have a vaccine, that now it's just going to go bye-bye and disappear, because the fact of the matter, especially for those of us that are saved, especially for those of us that are in the church, is it just may get darker, and it just may get worse, and it just may get harder before it ever gets better, but your light ought to shine that much the more brighter. Now, if I was to light a candle, it wouldn't make much of a difference, because I have this big behind photography light on right now. But when I light the candle in the dark room, you may not see anything else, but you're gonna see the candle. Now, if everything around us is dark, why can the world not see the saints? If the saints are not in the church, and now we are going back and forth, and we're in the Walmart, and we're in the food line, and we're at the gas station, even though we said we weren't going nowhere, for some reason, all of a sudden, we always need gas in our car. They should be able to see the light, even though we are not in the church. They should be able to see us shining, even though we are not where they may expect of us. They should be able to see us and the God that we serve, us reflecting his holiness, us reflecting his love, us reflecting whom it is that he said that he is, if we truly are this city set on this hill and this light that cannot be hid. I'm reminded of the scripture, 2 Corinthians 6:17, that will read to us, wherefore come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. And I read the scripture for a reason, because here lies the problem and here lies our dilemma. Because the fact of the matter is, and many can testify to this, because even in despair and even in grief and even in turmoil, your light can and will shine, but you run into the issue of a dim light when you're too close to the bottom of the hill that you were assigned to. Your task and my task is to shine a light that all of the city can see, not be found as the life of the party that they're throwing, not be found smoking what they're smoking, drinking what they're drinking, and doing all that they are found doing. My task and your task is to share the gospel and not share in the sin. But too many of us are finding ourselves with a compromise in our walk. We're finding ourselves, we're saints, yeah. We're saved, yeah. We know how to do ministry, yeah. We know how to do church, yeah. But when are we going to address the fact that many of us have a limp that we are not trying to tend to?
Come on.
When are we going to address the fact that many of us are operating at a lower than expected level that God has asked of us, and we're trying to ignore the fact that we are doing so? When are we going to address the fact that many of us are watered down, and we're trying to operate from a place from which we are watered down, and now we're frustrated because we're watered down, and we can't understand, well, God, I said what you wanted me to say. I showed up and did A, B, and C. Why aren't souls being saved? And why aren't they receiving me like I want them to to receive me? Why isn't A, B, and C happening? Well, the fact of the matter is you yourself are watered down and you are hindering your spirit. Yes, the times are very hard. Yes, many are passing. Yes, death will never be easy. Death will never be something that you want to go through. Yes, there are certain situations, temptation comes. Yes, but yes, this is a youth service, but we are young adults mostly that I see on here. Temptation comes. Even in marriage, temptation comes. You still have to choose to walk right. Mm-hmm. The fact of the matter is 2020 should not have taken us out the way that some of us have been taken out. We should not have responded to the year the way some of us had responded. But the fact of the matter is we are watered down because we have a compromise in our walk. Naturally, if you hear that so-and-so has been compromised, A, B, and C, he, she, and they has been compromised, in most cases, you understand that something bad has happened, but for some reason today, my generation hears the word compromise, and we think that the generation before us is asking for too much. Mm-hmm. For some reason today, my generation, we hear that we're straying too far away from the landmark, and we think that the generation that survived before us, that you mean to tell me that if my leaders come to me, or my bishop or different one that I look up to in the gospel come to me and tell me I'm straying too far away from the landmark, I'm going to sit here and catch an attitude as if I haven't watched them all this time, defeat deception, as if I haven't watched them all this time overcome temptation, as if I haven't watched them all this time defeat the devices of the enemy and be wise to the wiles of the enemy. Our generation thinks that we know it all and we don't know a thing. I reminded of a preacher, I can't remember who it is, but he would say that you knows nothing. A lot of us need to come to the realization that you know nothing. When the generation before you tells you that you're straying too far away from the landmark, they are not stuck in their ways. They are not stuck in tradition. You indeed are straying too far away from the landmark. And the thing is, I'm reminded when my mom was living and I was growing up, she would say a hard head makes a soft behind. Too many of us have hard heads. Too many of us think we're grown. Too many of us think that we know better. So now we're finding ourselves with a soft behind. We're finding ourselves all, what was me and this, that, and the third, because we didn't want to listen to the warning when it came. Sister Tanya would say to us, prepare for war in a time of peace. We received the instruction in a time of peace, and when the war came, we forgot the instruction because we didn't want to hear it. We didn't think it applied to us. We were self-righteous and holier than thou. And now, look at some of us. Now we're struggling in a way that God never intended for us to struggle. Struggling with things that God gave us the victory over long ago. You have to be mindful of this compromise in your walk. Again, the fact of the matter is too many are compromising. Too many have a position or a title or a name or some sort of notoriety and have made the mistake of thinking that they have arrived. They've made that their reward. So since they've received what they want, they now do what they want. Too many have forgotten that the only thing that you and I really and the only thing that you and I truly deserve is death. And forgive me, I told you I may sound kind of blunt at certain points, but I have to say what it is God told me to say. But we have to be careful wanting everything that we want when we get tired. We have to be careful of saying what we deserve when we get tired. We're quick to say, I deserve this break. We're quick to say, I deserve this indulgence. We're quick to say, I deserve this fun. I deserve this relationship. I deserve to make this purchase. And though we say that with our lips and we say that to our saints and we try to justify whatever it is that we're doing, God knows our hearts and he can hear what it is that we're really saying. Because, we said that outside of our lips and we said that outside of our mouth. But what we really said to God was, I deserve to back up a little bit. I deserve to seek comfort outside of God. We said to him that we deserve to be a part of what he told us to separate from. We say to him, well, Lord, I deserve to give someone else my time now. We say to him that I deserve to do what I want with what I have. And we seem to forget that the only reason we have whatever it is that we have is because Jesus made a way for it. Dear servant, please hear me. Don't survive 2020 in every way, but spiritually, but all of you need to survive. Yes, I want you to survive mentally. Yes, I want you to survive physically. Yes, I want you to survive emotionally. But you need to be sure that if all else fails, yeah, if you go in, I'm not saying this will happen, but if I just so happen to go into the new year sick, if I just so happen to go into the new year, Lord, be my peace. As long as I'm spiritually stable, as long as I'm able to spiritually stand, that is what matters the most to me. I want to survive Hallelujah. 2020 spiritually because I understand what it's like to be dead. I understand what it's like to backslide. I understand Hallelujah. That God has already restored little old me, and I'm not going to sit here and act like I can just go back and forth as if he's, yes, he is a good God, but the thing is, mercy runs out. Grace, the disposition of grace that we are in will one day come to an end. I'm not going to play with my salvation as if I always have to have it, because I remember when God was not pleased with me, though I had spoken in tongues, though I had been baptized in the name of Jesus, though I was going around to different churches and reciting poems, though different ones were beginning to know my name. I remember when God was not pleased with me. Do not survive in every way but spiritually, but first and foremost, survive spiritually. Please hear me when I say to you, don't grow weary in well-doing. My brother, my sister, you have to persevere. Hallelujah. And like I said, sometimes we receive what it is that we want, and then we begin to do what we want. So I'm not going to ask you whether or not you're a servant, because maybe in your mind you think that you are and you're not. Maybe you really are a servant. I'm not even going to ask. That's between you and God. But I have to ask you what, or rather who and why are you serving? 2 Corinthians 4:18 was said to us, "But we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal." Too many are serving what is seen. Too many are serving to be seen. Too many are serving what they see, serving for the engagement and the exposure, serving for man to pat you on the back, serving in an effort to bargain with God, serving to receive. And when we don't receive what we want, now all of a sudden we don't feel like serving. But have we forgotten that serving isn't about what we receive, but rather what we give? Have we forgotten that a minister isn't one who simply preaches, but first and foremost serves? Have we forgotten that to whom much is Hallelujah. Given, much is required? So again, I have to ask you the question, who are you serving? Are you serving God, or are you serving yourself? Hallelujah. Are you serving God, or are you serving your dreams? Are you serving God, or Hallelujah. Are you serving your desires that many times are outside of his perfect will for you anyway? Hallelujah. Who are you serving? And while I pray and I hope and Hallelujah. I beg that your answer truly is God, and that you mean that from the bottom of your heart, even if it is the matter and the case and the fact that you are serving God, now I have to ask you, why are you serving? Are you serving because you understand that God has a need for you in his vineyard, or are you serving because you know that he's a rewarder of the faithful, and it just seems like the Bible way to get what you want, and then you're acting all new and like you don't know what I mean? I'll use myself as an example. If you know me personally, you understand that I have a desire for marriage, but if the only bride I get to be is the bridegroom to Christ, I will be satisfied. If you know me personally, you understand that I have a desire for children, and both my son and my daughter are already named and prayed over, but if the only birth I give is the fact that I witnessed to a soul one day, they went down in the name of Jesus, they spoke in another tongue, and then I get to see them in glory, I'll be satisfied. Again, I have to ask you the question, why are you serving? Are you serving because you love God, or are you serving because you're fearful? Are you serving because you want something and you know God will reward those who work for him, and God is faithful to those who are faithful to him? But are you serving because you love him just that much? And here I am saying I'm going to preach on the perseverance of the servant. And so far, I've only questioned your motives. So far, I've only asked you, do you love God like you say that you do? And here I am making it seem like you don't. But that's not for me to judge, in all honesty. But I had to ask you those questions. I had to ask you to get you to do a self-examination. Because if this point is for you, I really need you to humble yourself and submit to the fact that you need to hear this. But I had to ask those questions before I made this point, and the point is simply this. You're not tired because of the work of the ministry. You're tired because of you. You're not tired because you're out here doing what God has asked of you. You're tired because you're out here trying to live your best life. Because the fact of the matter is, it's a tiring thing to preach one thing, but to practice another. It's a tiring thing to listen to yourself all the time, but then when it's time to serve, now all of a sudden you want to have an ear to hear, but only for a moment. It's a tiring thing to run back and forth between the Lord's house and everybody else's house. It's a tiring thing to walk away from God one moment and then think that you're going to walk with him again, but it's just for a moment. And then, well, Lord, I got myself. Well, then you feel as though, you know what, I ain't for this. I'm going to go do me again. And then all of a sudden you think that you've gotten yourself together and you want to walk with God again, knowing that it's just for a season. It's just till you come out of whatever storm you're in. It's just till God does whatever it is that you want him to do. Lord, if you do this for me, I promise I'll serve you. 3 months later, you don't got comfortable with whatever storm you don't came out of. You don't got comfortable with whatever it is that you received, but now you're back doing you. It's a tiring thing to go back and forth. It's a tiring thing to surrender all to God, but then search and scramble for any and everything that you can take back. Someone needs to hear on tonight that you're not tired because of ministry. You're tired because of you. You claim to give God 100%, so he asks of 100% of you, but in all actuality, you only gave him 50%. You only gave him 75%. You only gave him 37%, and now it seems hard, and it seems like too much because you can't take 100 from 37. No way. Excuse me, no how will it work? No way, no how will it happen? You can't take 100 from any number less than 100. You're going to have that deficit. You're going to find yourself in debt. And even the fact of the matter is, and even the world understands that being fake will tire you out sooner or later. But for some reason here in the church, we think it's okay to fake it until we make it. But I have to say to you, don't blame God for you being tired. Say God is asking you for too much as if he doesn't know what you are capable of doing. Don't tell God that he's doing too much or asking him too much, or that's just too much to sacrifice, or that's just too much to give, when the fact of the matter is that is not the problem. You're just not giving what it is that you said that you were giving. Don't blame God for you being tired. Ask yourself, where do I need to readjust? Where do I need to come up at? Where do I need to go and check my surrenderance? Where do I need to go and check my submission? Where do I need to go and check and see if my love is what my love, if my love does as my love says? Where do I need to readjust? Matthew 11 and 30. And the reason I can say that, and I can say that with confidence, is because I'm reminded in Matthew chapter 11 that was said to us, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I'm reminded of verse 28 that would say unto us, come unto me all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. And as I prepare to head to my close, I can't look at you. I can't tell you to turn to your neighbor. I can't tell you to pat somebody in your back. I'm not going to steal somebody else's phrase, but just for a moment, talk back to me in the comments and tell me that I may get tired physically, but I won't get tired of serving. If you are a true servant, if you have gotten yourself together, if you are walking, yes, life happens, yes, things happen, but the fact of the matter is, you will not get tired of serving. I wish somebody would talk back into me in the comments and say to me that the soul I'm working with may tire my patience, but I won't get tired of witnessing. Because the fact of the matter is, sometimes people are difficult. You should understand that you yourself were probably difficult to somebody when they came to witness to you. You yourself probably didn't want to hear the gospel. You yourself probably didn't want to hear what these church folk had to say. I'm in a pew baby. I was saved at a young age, but I remember being young and my mom realizing that I was on a backward slope, and me walking up the street like, I really don't want to hear this right now, even though all I ever knew was church, even though all I ever knew was salvation. So sometimes that soul may be a lot. Sometimes you may be asked to do a lot. Sometimes it may take away your sleep because you have
to talk to them throughout the night. Sometimes you have to come out of your pocket and make sure a need is made for them. Sometimes you may have to buy them a meal. Sometimes you may have to pick them up. Sometimes you may have to snatch them out of harm's danger because, yeah, they know better and they didn't do better. And it just may be that you have to go and scoop the person. But can someone on today say that the soul may tire me out, but I will not get tired of witnessing. I will not get tired of being that example. I've been holding on to this promise for years, but Lord, I won't get tired of waiting on you. Somebody can talk back to me in the comments and say that, Lord, I heard you say, though I have yet to see you do, but Lord, I won't get tired of trusting, Lord. I won't get tired of hoping, and I won't get tired of being patient. Now, I'm not going to tell you to talk to me. I'm going to tell you to encourage yourself. I know that your mics are off if you're on. Hallelujah. If you're in your comfort of your home, you can say what you want is your home. But for a moment, talk to yourself and tell yourself, Lord, I won't get tired of holding on, Lord. I won't get tired of shining my light, Lord. I won't get tired of consecrating myself, Lord. I won't get tired of sanctification, Lord. I won't get tired of growing. I won't get tired of holiness. I won't get tired of doing what it is, God, that you asked me to do. I won't get tired. I no ways tired. I remember hearing this song growing up, and it would simply say, no, I'm not tired yet. And then it would say again, no, I'm not tired yet. I can't tell you the question the songwriter was asked, but I can tell you that they didn't get tired. I can't tell you if there were any other lyrics to the song, but I can tell you that when I personally sang these words, they eventually stopped being lyrics and became a declaration until they became a reality. I found out why the Psalms would say to us to sing hymns and to have a song in our hearts, because sometimes they turn out not just to be a song, but to be a prayer. Please, please hear me, dear servant. I need you to persevere. The Lord needs you to persevere. The souls that you have been assigned to need you to persevere. The Lord will be your strength. The Lord will be your help. The Lord will be your comfort. The Lord will be your peace. The Lord will be a mind regulator. I can testify to that. I can testify to the fact that he will heal the brokenhearted. I can testify to the fact that he will make flesh turn flesh the stony heart. I can testify to the fact that he will take away the pain, that he would take away the hatred. Whatever it is that you think that he cannot heal, I can tell you right now, he can heal those things that you don't talk to anyone about, those struggles that you don't voice out or you don't give a voice to. I'm letting you know on today that God can heal, that Jesus makes the difference, and that God wants to be your strength, but you have to allow him to be your strength. We're not going to turn to other things being our strength. We're not going to turn to sin being our strength. We're not going to be out here smoking any and everything because we need a relaxation. We need a break. We're not going to be out here drinking any and everything because we need a break. We're not going to be out here sleeping with any and everybody because we need a break. We're not going to be found in everyone's house. Well, I didn't do A, B, and C, yet you were still not where you needed to be simply because you need a break. We're not going to turn to everything but God because of 2020. 2020 is no excuse. COVID is no excuse. Trump may have worked your nerves, but Trump is no excuse. You may not be a fan of Biden, but Biden is no excuse. You may want to leave America altogether, but the fact of the matter is your circumstances are no excuse for you to do what it is that you want to do, for you to live any way that you want to live, because the fact of the matter, it was said from the jump. It was said from the beginning that this home is not our home, that this world is not our world. We're just passing through. We're just here to be a witness. When God decided to come down in flesh and God decided to come down and die, he was here for a moment, but the life he lived testified. Before we thank God, thankful for the fact that he died on the cross. We are thankful for the fact that he made salvation available unto us. We are thankful for the fact for the tearing of the veil, but the fact of the matter and the thing still remains true that before he got to that year and whatever year it was, he lived a life that was a testimony. He lived a life that people were able to witness to. So when it was time to preach this salvation, they remembered, oh, well, I remember him do this miracle. Oh, I remember when he said this, and it didn't make sense then. It went over my head then, but now it makes sense. It was a parable unto me then, but now I have this revelation. I don't know what your besetting sin may be. I don't know what your comfort may be. I don't know what you think is a little sin when the fact is there are no big sin, little sin, everything is sin. So if you're out here eating everything because it's a hard time for you, the fact of the matter is that in itself is a sin. But the case may be that your life, the point I wanted to make, your life needs to testify to the fact that Jesus saved. Your life needs to testify that Jesus is the light. Your life needs to testify to the fact that Jesus is God, that God is who he said he is. So when you receive the opportunity to be that witness, they see you living what you already preach. They see you preaching what you already live. They've already seen you live this. So their servant, please hear me say, please persevere. There's still a work to do. Please don't find yourself absent without leaving this here army of the Lord. Please, whatever you need to do, get yourself together. Please keep holding on. Please stay in this fight. Please don't give up now. Please don't let a quit be found in you. Please don't throw in the towel. Please give God your all. Please take heed to his voice. Please depend on him and not yourself, him and not your friends, him and not that one that gets you whatever, him and not all these other things and all these other people and all these other outlets and all these other whatever. Please, please, please depend on God. Please keep going. Let your response to 2020 be, no, I'm not tired yet. No, I'm, yes, matter of fact, yes, I am still running. Yes, I am still holding on to what I believe. Yes, I am still. Yes, you, then when they ask you, you still doing this Jesus thing? Yes, honey, I am. If Pastor Harris was on here, she would say that I'm not going nowhere.
Yes, she would.
There's no quit that's about to be found in you. I'm running for my life and I'm running all the way. Let that be your response to 2020. I am praying
Thank you, Lord.
That you persevere. Please.
Thank you, Lord.
Please, if you hear nothing else I have said on today,
hallelujah,
hear me when I said persevere, and you will only persevere,
hallelujah,
by depending on Jesus. You will only persevere by allowing him to be God in your life. Yes, life happens to us all, the saved and the unsaved alike. But if you want God to be, if you allow God to be who he is, you're going to survive it all. You are going to survive it all. I often look back on my own testimony and I'm reminded of things that I remember saying to God, Lord, if A, B, and C happen, I don't know what I'm going to do. If this person's not around, Lord, I don't think I can survive that. Lord, if this person dies, well, Lord, you're going to have to resuscitate me. I am a testimony to the fact that God is a keeper. He is a mind regulator.
Yes, he is.
He is a comfort. But the thing is, you have to let him be these things.
Thank you, Jesus.
There are many things and many people that I could have turned to when various things happen. But the fact of the matter is, I would have found myself in sin, found myself in a backsliding state, and there is no guarantee God would have restored me for that second time. There is no guarantee that God would have given me yet another chance after ruining all these other chances. So if God is here and you are on this today and you need another chance, I pray that you take heed to it today. We're going to go into prayer in a few moments, but I pray that even after we come off the prayer call, end the live, end the service, that you take your own moment with God. Let him know what, be vulnerable. Lord, this hurts. Lord, this is not fair. Lord, I'm trying, but I can't seem to do this. Lord, I keep falling here. Lord, I need you to be my strength. Lord, the Sunday school lesson for tomorrow is, it talks about the fact that greater is he that is in you than he that is within the world. He that is in the world, excuse me, you already have the power. If you are saved, if you are filled with the Holy Ghost, you already have the power to overcome. You just have to walk in that power. You just have to be led of the Spirit. Pastor talked about the importance of recognizing the voice of God. You just have to hear God when he tells you what it is that he needs you to do and submit to it. So that's my message. That's all I got to say. I thought I was going to be on here 20 minutes. I probably didn't. I probably exceeded that. I don't know. But I'm thankful to all of you that have joined. I pray that you receive something out of this. Again, I said I'm not about to preach you happy. I want to preach you strong. I pray that you have some strength as we end this year. I pray that you have some strength as we prepare to go into this next year. Again, your laptop is dying. I pray that whatever the case may be, whatever you're dealing with, I pray that you know that you can depend on God. if you are not saved, and when I say that, I want to be very specific, because the Bible gives us specifics. It's behind me. If you have not been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, if they didn't say, now I baptize you in the name of Jesus, then I want to invite you to be baptized. Of course, we're on virtual. We can't do it right now, but a way will be made to be able to take you down in the water. If you are not in the Salisbury, the Marva area, if you're not around this area, I will connect with a church that I know will take you down in the name of Jesus. If you desire to go to be baptized, unplug anything but the light. If you desire to be baptized, please reach out. Please comment. Please let us know, and we will make sure that happens. If you have not been filled with the Holy Ghost, with the evidence and speaking in tongues, please let us know. We will. The thing is, if when two or three are gathered, God is in the midst. And we have to pray with you over the phone until it's good. If we have to pray with you over the phone, we have to FaceTime you, if we could come and meet you, or whatever the case may be, we will do that. And again, if for whatever reason we cannot contact with you, we will make sure that we find someone that can come, that can be in contact with you and also pray with you until you receive the Holy Ghost. Because the fact of the matter is, I'm saying be strong in the Lord and this and the third, but some may not have experienced God the way I have. Some may not be able to give the testimony that I can give simply because they don't have the salvation that I have, but I want you to say that it is the best change that will ever happen. And it's the best thing that would ever happen to you. I know some say their wedding is the best thing, their marriage. I know some say their kids are the best thing. But the fact of the matter is, when you experience the newness of life, there everything else just becomes a close second. It's still up there, but it is a close second to having God dwelling on the inside of you. So again, if you do not know Jesus, if you have not been baptized, if you have not received the Holy Ghost, reach out to us and we will make that connection. Even if it's you're watching the replay and you're receiving start the week, still reach out to me. Still reach out to whomever you see that you know, whomever, whatever your contact is, reach out to that person. Even if it's not one of us and you have someone on your job that, well, my coworker been preaching that and now I'm hearing it again, let this be your confirmation. Go and hit that coworker up and let them know that you want to know more. If whatever, whomever it is, that family member of yours that you get sick of when they come to the holidays because it seems like all they ever do is preach and do the long race. The fact of the matter is they're trying to be that witness to you. Reach out to them. Let them know that you want to hear more. We're going to do things a little bit differently on today. I'm going to have the general prayer as we end the service, but I also want to have a focused prayer for the youth of Calvary specifically and for all those that have joined. So what we're going to have is we're going to have Brother Brandon. Well, actually, I'm going to go into, no, we're going to have Brother Brandon come unmute his mic. He's going to lead us in a prayer just for a few minutes. He's going to pray that God comforts us as we do what it is that he has asked of us. Because like I said, various things happen to even the servants. There's an attack on the servant. There's an attack on the ones that dedicate their life to Christ. It's not always the fact that you're out here sinning. It's not always the fact that you're out here just loosey-goosey or whatever the case may be. Sometimes it's just the fact that the enemy is trying to take you out. So I'm going to have Brother Brandon come and pray that we be comforted as we are working, persecuted for the gospel's sake, whatever the case may be, that we be comforted and we turn to God for that comfort rather than whatever we may have turned to before this service. After that, we're going to have Sister Trina come, and she's going to pray that we allow God to heal us, because sometimes God wants to heal us and we don't want to go through the healing process. We're like, Nope, Lord, you're not touching that because that hurts. But the fact of the matter is, if God don't touch it, how can you heal it? So we're going to have her come and lead us in a word of prayer for healing, that we allow God to heal us so that we can give our 100% and our full selves to him. Excuse me. After that, Minister Brianna is going to come, and she's going to pray that we have a heart to win souls, that we have a heart to be a witness. Because at the end of the day, when it's all said and done, that is the goal, to live a saved life and then bring somebody with us. And after Minister Brianna, I'll come back on, I'll end the prayer, and I'll also serve as dismissal, and that will be the end. And if you desire to give an offering, I made a comment, I don't know if it's still up there, but if you desire to give an offering or anything like that to support the youth ministry at Mount Calvary, you can do so through Cash App or by contacting Lady Shelton. If you desire to pay by card, the cash tag is MCAC, the number one. And we thank you. So, Brother Brandon, it's in your hands.
Lord, just want to say thank you for bringing us to this point of service, Lord. Asking that you will continue to have your way in Jesus' name, Lord. We thank you. Asking you for comfort in Jesus' name. Asking, Lord, you already told us in your word how that we will be persecuted, Lord, for your name's sake, Lord. I'm just asking, Lord, that even in persecutions, Lord, that you will continue to give us the strength, Lord, to go on, even though our bodies may feel or even get tired, Lord, but we just asking that you will give us the strength to continue to work with souls, even in the midst of what's going on right now, Lord. Help us or whoever is will broadcast live, or just, Lord, let the word get out, Lord. I'm asking whosoever and wherever they are, Lord, I'm asking that you will reach them where they are, Lord. Strengthen and encourage them, Lord. Bless even, Lord, the people who we witness and evangelize to around here in this area, Lord. Continue to give our outreach team strength, Lord, that they need. Send comfort, Lord. Send comfort to them, Lord, and every household, dear God, who's been going through, Lord, and who's just been affected, Lord, in the midst of this pandemic, Lord. We're just asking for strength because we know that you're able, Lord, to turn things around. We're just trusting and believing in you, Lord. Thanking you for everything that you've already done, Lord, what you continue to do. Lord, asking that you will continue to send joy, peace, healing, and strength. Lord, we thank you for all these things. Lord, continue to bless Sister Carla, who brought forth the word on tonight, everything that has happened on this virtual live, Lord, though bless all those who was in attendance on tonight watching, Lord, strengthen even them in their homes, Lord. We just want to say thank you for all these things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah. God, we thank you, Lord God, for another opportunity, Lord God, just to come to your throne of grace, Lord God. We ask, Lord God, that you search our heart, Lord God, and that you know us, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Oh, God, we ask right now that you heal the hidden parts, Lord God, the parts that we've tried to tuck away, Lord God, because we did not feel like dealing with it, God. Oh, God, we ask, Lord God, that you stretch us out and humble us, Lord God, in this season, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Oh, God, help us to heal, Lord God, in the places that are hurting, Lord God, in the places that we've tried to put band-aids on, Lord God, but it's time to rip them off and let you deal with it, God. In the name of Jesus, we will no longer hide, Lord God, in our sins, Lord God. We will no longer hide, Lord God, in our discomfort, Lord God. We will no longer hide, God, in our fear. Hallelujah. We will no longer hide, Lord God, in the comfort of others, Lord God. Hallelujah, God. But we will have an ear to hear from you, Lord God. We will silence ourselves, Lord God, that we will surrender to you, Lord God, and hear clearly what you are saying in this season, God. Hallelujah, God. We want to give ourselves to you, Lord God, completely, Lord, so that when we see you, Lord God, it will be a complete yes, a total yes. Oh, God, we want to hear well done, thy good and faithful servant. Hallelujah, God. Let us be transparent in this season, Lord God. Let us be honest enough, Lord God, to go to you with the things that we are uncomfortable with, the things that we are dealing with, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Heal us, Lord God, from the inside out, Lord God, that we may be an example to others who are hurting, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we want to walk in victory, Lord God. We claim the victory, Lord God. The victory is in you, God. We trust you, God, in this season, Lord God. Close the eyes of the naysayers, God. Hallelujah. We ask, Lord God, that you open our eyes, Lord God, that we may see your will in our life, God. Hallelujah, God, and we will go forth, Lord God, humbly, Lord God, into your purpose, God. We will not bow down to sin. Hallelujah, God, but we will walk in victory, God, in this season, Lord God, in this time, Lord God, that you have appointed for us, Lord God, despite our shortcomings, God. You have called us to be a people, Lord God, after your own heart, and we will trust and believe in your word, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you right now, Lord, for your grace, dear God. Thank you, Lord God, for your mercy. Thank you for your love and kindness, Jesus. Thank you for your spirit, Lord God. Thank you for being mindful of us time and time and time again, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God, for your mercy that is renewed every single moment, every single morning, Lord Jesus. We just thank you for having so much patience with us, God. Lord God, for taking up the time, Lord Jesus, not being weary with us, God. Lord, we ask, Lord God, right now, Lord God, just to give us a heart for your people, Lord Jesus, a true heart for souls, God, not just a burden, Lord Jesus, but a compassion there, God. Let us not move to reach out to people for fear, Lord God, fear of where they're going to go, fear of where we're going to go if we don't reach them, God, but a heart of love, a true heart of compassion, dear God, a heart that's merciful, Lord Jesus. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, that we will not break, Lord God, the bruised reed, dear God. Lord, give us wisdom on what to say, Lord God, to the hurting people, Lord God, what to say to the broken, God. Give us a heart of love, Lord Jesus, for the murderer, God. Give us a heart of love for the molester, for the rapist, Lord Jesus. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, we'll not be picky and choosy with our love, Lord God. Equip us to love those that hurt us, God. Equip us to love those, Lord God, even as they are stoning us, Lord Jesus. What a perfect love, Lord Jesus. Even as you have given your blood for us, Lord Jesus, I pray that we'll be willing, Lord God, to shed our blood for another, Lord God, that they may be able to hear you, God. I pray, Lord Jesus, that we will see you, Lord God, beyond ourselves, Lord God, to seek your mission, Lord God, beyond us, Lord Jesus. Lord God, to seek ye first the kingdom, Lord God, not getting so caught up in everything that's going on here, Lord Jesus, but to remember that we are citizens of heaven. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, give us a mind to want to serve you, God, a heart, Lord God, to a servant's heart, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. I'm praying, Lord God, that you would just stir up a hunger and a thirst for your righteousness. For your word says, if we have a hunger and thirst for your righteousness, then we shall be filled, Lord God. Stir up the hearts, Lord God, of those that we come in contact with, God. We pray, Lord, that you would just strategically, oh God, put us in the path of those that are hungry for you, God. And if we come into contact with someone that is not hungry, God, that something may be said, Lord Jesus, to prick a little bit of faith in them, Lord God. We know that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, Lord Jesus. I'm praying, oh God, that you will lead us, Lord God. I pray that we'll not be weary and well-doing, Lord Jesus. God, I'm asking right now, Lord, that you would just touch the pastors, the bishops, the preachers, oh God, that are serving the kingdom right now, Lord God. Lord, strengthen their heart, dear God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. I pray, Lord, that we all have a mind to serve, Lord God. Lord Jesus, not a mind to be in the front, not a mind, Lord God, Lord, to want our name, Lord God, to be in front, but a mind and a heart to serve, Lord God. Lord, I pray, Lord Jesus, a heart of humility, Jesus, over your people, God, that will not walk in pride, thinking that we know the perfect way, Lord Jesus, but that we will humble ourselves, Lord God, before you, Lord God, asking you what it is that you desire for us to do, Lord Jesus. Lord, even in the midst of sorrow and pain there, God, that we not be so prideful, Lord Jesus, Lord God, but we'll seek your face, Lord God, humble ourselves in your tears, Lord Jesus, humble ourselves in your blood, Lord God. I'm praying right now that we will lean on you, Lord Jesus, for strength, God, knowing that you know what is best for us, God. I pray that we might know, Lord Jesus, that the cross is what's best for us, that carrying our cross is what's best for us, Lord Jesus. Not always seeking comfort in here and there and this thing and that thing, God, but seeking comfort through the cross, seeking comfort through laying ourselves down in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Help us to be more like you, Lord Jesus. Remember that we are but clay, Lord Jesus. Remember our frame, that it is your breath in our lungs, Lord Jesus. I pray that we'll be mindful, Lord God, to use this breath that you have given us for things of God, Lord Jesus, that we will use this breath that you have given us to give you the glory, not for the things of ourselves. I pray that we not waste the breath that you have given us, Lord Jesus. Waste your breath to go out and do things that are not of God. Lord Jesus, I'm just asking right now, Lord God, that you would just keep us, Lord God. Let us be merciful to one another, knowing that if we are not merciful, we shall not receive mercy, Lord God. Let us have a heart of forgiveness, Lord Jesus, knowing if we do not forgive, then we shall not be forgiven, Lord Jesus. I'm just asking, Lord God, that you would just touch your people. I'm praying that we may be one in the spirit, even as you are one, Lord Jesus, having a heart, Lord Jesus, Lord God, of you, Lord Jesus, a heart that is like your heart, dear God, that our desires will be lined up with your desires, that our will be lined up with your will, Lord God, Lord Jesus, that will not just come before you, Lord Jesus, with a whole bunch of crying and then no change, Lord Jesus, but I'm praying, Lord God, that we'll have a heart of change, not
not a heart of emotion, but a heart of change, a heart that will repent, a heart that will turn from our wicked ways, not thinking that we know everything, Jesus. Lord God, I'm just praying right now, Lord God, Lord Jesus, that you will stir up the heart, dear God, that has waxed cold in the name of Jesus, God. Give them a burning heart of love, Lord Jesus, a heart to serve you, God, no matter what it is, oh God, they have to turn away from, Lord Jesus, no matter who or what it is, they got to let go, Lord Jesus, to have a heart to let it go, Lord Jesus, knowing that you are able to keep, Lord Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God, Lord Jesus, for your people today, Lord Jesus. Lord God, strengthen us, God. Keep us, God. Cover us, Lord Jesus. Cover us, Lord Jesus. Let us know, Lord Jesus, that your way is what's best for us, that you know what's best for us, Lord God. Let us take the humble way, Lord Jesus. Lord God, set ourselves aside for our brother and our sister, Lord Jesus. Lord God, I'm asking you right now, Lord God, to continue to give us a heart for souls, Lord Jesus. I pray that we have a heart for you so that we have a heart for souls every day, seeking to be more like you, Lord Jesus, not seeking to be churchy, but seeking to be the church in the name of Jesus, God. I pray, Lord Jesus, that we will seek your face, Lord God, and not just your hand in the name of Jesus, God, that we will study out the scriptures, Lord Jesus, to know what it is that you desire for us, Lord God. Well, we just want to thank you, God. I pray, Lord Jesus, for a willing heart, Lord Jesus, to stay in your presence, God, Lord Jesus, not to put a time limit on you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God, a heart that seeks you first in all things, Lord God, not just in time, not just in the time of day that we come to you, God, but in all things, God, Lord Jesus, giving you what you are worthy of, God. We humble ourselves, Lord Jesus. We humble ourselves before you, Lord God. Lord Jesus, it is you that has made us and not we ourselves, Lord God. We humble ourselves before you, Jesus. Lord, we just want to thank you, God. Thank you for your grace, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God, for your love. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your mercy, God. Complete the work that you've started in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we thank you, God, for all that you've done, all that you're doing, all that is to come, oh God. I'm praying for every young and young at heart under the sound of my voice, oh God. I'm praying for every youth of Calvary, oh God, for every youth of the churches that we fellowship, oh God. I'm praying, oh God, that you be our strength, oh God. I'm praying, oh God, that we allow you to be our strength, oh God, that we allow you to be our comfort, oh God. I pray that we do not be offended or we do not be ashamed, oh God, of our salvation, God. I'm praying, oh God, that we do not grow weary in well doing, oh God. I'm praying, oh God, that we give you all that you have asked of us, God. Praying, oh God, that we, God, be the servants, God, be the leaders, God, be the ministers, God, be what it is that you have asked of us, God. I pray, oh God, that we walk in what it is that you have called us to, oh God. I pray, oh God, that we not run from you, oh God, that we run closer to you, God. I pray, oh God, that we not use our age as an excuse as while we cannot do what it is that you are asking us of, God, even though you have begun to ask us, God. I pray, oh God, that we not use our age as an excuse, God, to hide, oh God, what it is that you have placed on the inside of us, God. But I'm praying, oh God, that we, God, do what you have asked of us, God. Do what we need to do, oh God, in order to be who it is that you have said that we are, God, in order to be a help to the ministry that you have assigned us to, oh God, in order to reach the souls that you have assigned us to, God. I'm praying, oh God, for Daniel, God. I'm praying, Jesus, for Trey, God. I'm praying, Jesus, for Jason, God. I'm praying for Kendra, God. I'm praying for Sean, God. Praying even for Aria and Ahmad, oh God. I'm praying, Jesus, for CJ, God. I'm praying for Chris, oh God. I'm praying for Brandon, Jesus. I'm praying for my CJ, God. I'm praying for Jayshawn, oh God. I'm praying for Bree, God. I'm praying for Jayden, God. I'm praying for Bree Howell, oh God. I'm praying for Julian, God. I'm praying for Keshira, God. I'm praying for her boy, God, and her siblings, God. I'm praying for Mariah, Jesus. I'm praying for Zion, God. I'm praying for Sister Trina, God. I'm praying for Amari, God, and Amaya, Jesus. I'm praying for Elise, oh God. I'm praying for Caleb, God. I'm praying
for Caleb, God. I'm praying, Jesus, for William, God, for Alan, God, for Dorian, God, and Deshaun, oh God. I'm praying for Daniel Coates, oh God. I'm praying for Jeremy, God. I'm praying, Jesus, for the Xavier, God, and Toronto, God, for Teron, God, and Dante's, God. I'm praying, Jesus, for Rupi, God. I'm praying for Sister Habitoria, God. I'm praying for Little Koya, God. I'm praying for the Shandra, God. I'm praying, Jesus, for the various ones, God. If I miss their name, God, you know who they are. Praying, oh God, for little Danielle, oh God. We're praying, oh God, not just for our youth, oh God, but we're praying, God, for our families, God. We're praying, oh God, for the youth in the churches that we fellowship with, God. Praying that you remember the youth of One Way, God. Praying that you remember the youth of Rainbow, God. Praying that you remember the youth of both Infam Bowie and Infam Laurel, God. Praying, God, that you remember the youth at All the Morning Stars, God. Praying, God, that you remember the youth at Debts and Holiness, God. Praying, God, that you remember the youth all throughout AFFI, God, all throughout District 1, God, all whatever fellowship, whatever organization we find ourselves in, God. We're praying, oh God, that you remember the youth on tonight, oh God, whatever they stand in need of, God, whatever we are burdened, we are maybe burdened with, God, whatever we may be holding on, God. I pray on today that we give it to you, God, and that we do not pick it back up, that we do not attempt to touch it again, God. I pray, God, that we surrender all to you on today, oh God. I pray, oh God, that we, God, not be afraid, oh God, what it is that you are asking of us, God. I'm praying, Jesus, that you have your way with us, through us, and in us, God. Let it no longer be said, oh God, that we were doing what we want, God. Let it no longer be said, oh God, that we are bringing a reproach to the gospel. Let it no longer be said, oh God, that the young people just want to do them, or they don't want to listen to anyone, oh God, but allow every young person, oh God, whose name I call, whose face comes across my mind, be an example, God, to where it is that you have placed them, God, whether they be in school, God, whether they be working, whatever the case may be, oh God. We're praying a special prayer for every young person in leadership, God. We're praying a special prayer, God, for every young person, oh God, that give that extra level of sacrifice, God. I'm praying, God, that you pour back into them everything that they are pouring out, God. Let it not be said that they are pouring from an empty vessel, God. Let it not be said that they are serving from an empty vessel and giving from an empty vessel, but God, put those people in position to pour back into them. In the name of Jesus Christ, God, we thank you in advance. Amen and amen. Again, we thank you for joining the service. We thank you for giving if you gave. We thank you for staying if you stayed. We thank you for sharing the love. I truly pray, hallelujah, Jesus. I pray that you have, hallelujah, Jesus. I pray that you have got something out of the service on today. I pray that you are strengthened on today. Even if you already shared it, you know what? Send this to someone who you want to be strengthened. Send this to a young person that you see giving. And you're wondering, I don't understand how they do it. The fact of the matter is, they just might be at their breaking point, and they are waiting for someone to realize, yes, I'm in ministry, yes, I'm in leadership, yes, I'm in position, but times are hard, and this week is hard. Be sensitive to the Spirit on this weekend, on this week, and be sure to encourage a young person. You don't even have to be a young person. Of course, my heart is for the young people. Be sensitive to the Spirit, because there are many people out here putting on facades. There are many people out here who, they come and we preach, and we come and we do praise and worship, and we come and we play whatever instrument that we do. We come and we fill our lane or do our service, and we do what's asked of us. But when we go home, we're having sleepless nights. When we go home, we're crying in our sleep and crying in our dreams, because when we're up, we don't want to say what's really going on. Be sensitive to the Spirit on this week, and make sure that you encourage someone. But again, I pray that you have received something out of this. I love you all. God bless you all. Thank you for being a support. And until we see again, until we come back in January, I pray that all is well with you. And I truly do hope, and I truly do expect to see you strong in the new year. God bless you all.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
God bless you. We love you, Carla.
Love you too.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Bless y'all. Enjoy the service tonight.
Glad to hear it from you. God bless y'all.